Good morning and welcome in the lecture series of Automation and Robotics. Today's agenda of the discussion is the classification and type of automated transfer machines. So what is an automated transfer machine? First, we have to understand. Basically, in the industry, there are automated flow lines. These lines are consisting of several machines or workstations which are linked together by work handling devices which can be transferred the part between the stations. And the main objectives of the use of flow lines automation are: first one is to reduce the labor cost, because the many workers which are associated to move the part from the one place to the another place, it can be easily done with the help of the automated transfer machines. And the second objective is to increase the production rate. So once we can reduce the idle time or unproductive time, means if you minimize this time by using the automated transfer machines, the production rate will also increase. So next is to minimize the distance moved between the operations. Sometimes what happening, it is required to set the timing between the one machine to the another machine, and it can be easily done with the help of the automated transfer machines by minimizing the distance between the operations. So next is to achieve specialization of operations, then to achieve the integration of operations. As I said that sometimes what happening, the one operation is integrated with the previous one. So you can say that if the one operation is finished, then the next operation will be sequenced. So therefore, we have to integrate all these operations. So this can be easily done with the help of ATMs. Now, there are basically mainly two types of automated flow lines. One is the in-type line and the second is the rotary types. In-type lines consist of sequence work stations, more or less straight line arrangement. You can observe here in this diagram where there are six stations. So the raw part workpiece is moving from the one place and it will move in a straight path, right? So and the process will be done over stations, and you will get the finished part out at the end. So therefore, you can observe here that there are very less turns in the case of in-type line. And the second is the factory layout limitation, or sometimes other reasons, is also responsible for the straight line configurations. Next type of the called as the rotary types. Now in this type of work, parts are indexed around a circular table, or sometimes it is called as dial. So you can observe here this table in this figure, that this table is moving at in a continuous speed, or you can say at a constant speed, or sometimes the speed is governed or decided depending upon the processing of the part. So what happening, the workstations are stationary and usually located around the periphery of the dial. So the parts on the table are positioned and processing stations for the operations. So there are various types of work method transports. Method of work transports are type of, you can say, the continuous transfer. Second one is the intermission or synchronous transfer. And the last one is the asynchronous transfer. Continuous transfer means, in this method, the work part are moved continuously at a constant speed, right? So what happening, there are some other elements which are associated, like robots which are doing this exercise to pick and place on the work table, and this work table will move continuously, and robots will perform its duty within a stipulated time. So this requires the work heads to move during the processing in order to maintain continuous registration with the work part. What is the meaning of this? That what happening, sometimes what happening, the person is also moving along with the work, and doing its assembling operations, you can say the welding operations or any kind of small machining or assembly operations with the help of the work table. So this is a continuous type of transfer machines. Next is the intermittent transfer. In this case, what happening in this method, the work pieces are transported with an intermittent or discontinuous motions. The work stations are fixed in this position and the part are moved between the stations, then registration. What happening in this case, all the parts are transported at the same time, and for this reason is called synchronous transfer system. So therefore, what happening in this case, these operators who are working, they will not move, right? So we have to decide the positioning of the workpiece for a particular period of time. The part will stationary, it will not move like a earlier type of transfer. It means the continuous transfer, the part will be stationary, operator will perform its duty or its work on the machine or parts. So what happening in this case, this is can be easily decided with the help of discontinuous type of motions. So there are so many mechanisms which are available to perform such type of operations. Next is the asynchronous type transfer. Here what happening in this system, each work parts to move to the next station when processing at the current station has been completed. So in this case, in each parts move independent dependently of the other parts. Suppose what happening if they are, suppose if we take the two work stations and we have to transfer the part from the one work station to the another work station. Suppose on the second work station, if the processing is going on and if the job on the work one station is finished, then it will not move until the processing on the second part is finished. So what happening, there is a coordination between the one work station to the another work station. So therefore, the asynchronous transfer system more flexible than the other two systems. So it is used where there are one or more manually operated stations and cycle time variation station. Because the cycle time is not constant, so we have to just synchronize, or you can say that the operations, so that therefore what happening, the cycle time can be varied in that case and we have to wait for the next operation. Now, if we talking about the different types of the transfer mechanism, the first mechanism is you can say that linear transfer mechanism, where we have to consider the walking beam system. So as I told you that there are two types of transfer mechanism. One is the linear transfer mechanism, depending upon the type of transfer system, and the second is the rotary transfer mechanism. So in the first category, first is the walking beam system. Now in this case, what happening, work parts are lifted up from their workstation location by the transfer bar and move one position ahead to the next station. So you can see here that in this mechanism, you can easily understand this mechanism. There is a piston and a cylinder arrangement which is connected with the slider, and this slider will work move on the basis of the four bar parallel mechanism. So what happening, this slider will uplift the you can say that this bench, and the work piece will move to the next position. So therefore what happening, the transfer of bar then lower the pens into the next, which position them more accurately for the positioning or processing. So this is it. You can say in the few figures, you can observe here that how this work is positioning and transferring from one to the another place. Next is the power roller conveyor system. This is another type of a continuous type of system and a line type of system, where you can say that power is rollers are used to transfer the workpiece from one station to the another station. You can observe here in this picture that how wheels or this elements are transferring for a long distance, right, from one place to the another place. And this type of system is used in a general stock handling system as well as in the automated flow lines. So here in this case, the conveyors can be used to move pens or pallets processing flat riding surfaces. So rollers can power by either of two mechanisms. The first is the belt drive, which is connected all the rollers, in which a flat moving belt and roller provides the rotation of the rollers by friction. So friction is responsible here to transfer the power from one point to the another point. Next is the chain drive conveyor system. You can see here that in the system, there is a tension wheels, indexing mechanism, working carriers, and this whole mechanism is connected on a base. So what happening, this there is a center distance which is fixed here. It cannot be a flexible, and we have to provide that a chain or a flexible steel belt which is used to transport the work carriers. So the chain is driven with by the pulley in either and over and under configuration, in which the pulleys turn about a horizontal axis or an around the corner configuration, in which the pulleys rotate about the vertical axis. So it can be used for continuous, intermittent, or asynchronous movement of the work parts. So in the asynchronous motion, this can be also achieved the system with the help of the chain and drive conveyor system. Next is the rotary transfer mechanism. The one case is the rack and pinion arrangement. See, rack and pinion arrangement, you are very much familiar to this mechanism. This mechanism is quite simple, but is not considered especially suited to a high speed operations, sometimes often associated with the indexing machines. So the piston, which is used to drive the rack, which causes the pinion gear, you can see here that, which is attached indexing table to rotate, and a clutch or other device is also used to provide the rotation in a desired direction. So here what happening, this is a piston which is connected with the rack, and this piston will give the motion to the rack in a reciprocating manner, and gear will move intermittently. So what happening, this will also move in a clockwise or unclockwise direction depending upon the positioning of the part. Next is the ratchet and pawl. This ratchet, you know that it is a device that allows linear or rotary motion in only one direction. You can see that while opening the nuts through the wheels, right? You can use this ratchet type of opening system because it can move only in one direction, and the other direction it is basically locked, or it preventing the motion in the opposite direction. So ratchet consists of a gear wheel and pivoting spring, which is a loaded finger called a pawl that engage the teeth. The spring for forcing it back and with a click into the depression before the next tooth. So see what happening here, that when the teeth are moving in the other direction, the angle of the pawl causes it to itch against tooth and stop further motion in that direction. Basically on the other direction it is locked, so it cannot move on the other direction. It is moving on in the same direction. Next is the Geneva mechanism. Geneva mechanism is another category of the mechanism where the driver is rotating continuously to index the table. So one indexing type of another wheel is used, and if the driver member has a six hole, you can see in this picture that the indexing mechanism, which is having a six holes for the six station dial indexing machine. So each turn of the driver will cause the table to advance 1/6 of a turn. So this is the beauty of this mechanism, that this driver is continuously rotated, and you can see here that a pin which is attached to the driver enters slot to index driven member. So what happening during this movement of the pin inside the slot, this driven member will not move. So you can say that this is the stationary period, and after that you will find out that this will move in the direction when it is rotating on this surface. So depending upon the surface or the configuration of the index, you can say that this driven member which is attached to the work table will govern the motion of the mechanism. Next is the cam mechanism. So cam mechanism is also used for the intermittent type of motions. So you can say that they are mostly used in the industry, despite that the fact that the cost of the cam is relatively high as compared to the alternative mechanism. The cam can be designed to give a variety of velocity and dwell characteristics. You know that dwell is the period where the follower is stationary, and during this case we are using the follower as a index place. So you can see that the cam has a configurations, and due to this its configuration, it will move continuously and the index place will turn depending upon the configuration on the cam. So there is a dwell period also on which we have to provide the stationary motion of the workpiece. So thank you very much.